Welcome everybody to today's post-game show. The post-game show today is coming, obviously, the day after the game, which is unusual because I was in attendance at the Raptors game last night as they faced off against the Memphis Grizzlies. A vlog from that game will be on Amateur TV, the second channel for Amateur Studios, if you'd like to watch that. But our post-game show for today covers our 98-91 loss to the Grizzlies, and a game the Grizzlies don't have Ja Morant, and we only score 91 points at home. And, like, this isn't even that great of a team, the Memphis Grizzlies, defensively. So there's a lot of problems to talk about with this Raptors team, so let's kind of get into it here. So throughout most of the game, the half-court offense was struggling. We had only 39 points at half. The second half was a little bit better. But I guess we want to talk about positives. The defense was better. Kept them to under 100 points. But we need to find a way to have a good offensive night that also coincides with a good defensive night. And that just really hasn't materialized really ever this season, or at least ever since at 6-3 start. We've now lost 10 of the last 13 games. And overall, I mean, like, again, defense was fine. Like, let's take a look here. Defense was fine. We kept the Grizzlies to under 40% shooting, under 30% shooting from the field. And, you know, we're also in that category of not great shooting in this one. And if you go down to the rebounding, this is where it gets a little bit concerning, because the Grizzlies out-rebounded us. It seemed like we just could not get a rebound on the defensive end. 18 offensive rebounds for them. ESPN doesn't have second chance points, but I assure you, the Grizzlies beat us up on those second chance points. I know they had around, I think they had at least 20 at halftime. They were getting a lot of points in those second chance settings because they were getting offensive rebounds. We were struggling to box out. We're struggling to get those rebounds. And when we were on offense, it was broken a lot of the time. The offense, especially when Fred VanVleet gets off the court, like, we have no choice but to play him 42 minutes in this one. Because every time VanVleet comes off the floor, this team absolutely crumbles. It crumbles without him on the floor. We don't have anybody who can run the half-court offense. And it was very apparent, even when he was on, that the half-court offense wasn't the best. The Grizzlies did a good job of making it difficult for Fred VanVleet in this. It made it very difficult for him. Dylan Brooks was guarding him. Dylan Brooks didn't have a great game. Fred VanVleet did a pretty good job on Dylan Brooks, but they kind of gave Fred VanVleet the Curry treatment that we gave Steph Curry in that game to make him have an off night. And VanVleet, you know, 15.6 for 13 isn't awful, but it was very difficult for Fred VanVleet to get his. Only 3 assists, which I'd like to see grow for VanVleet as well. It's just difficult when, you know, he's given the ball to Malachi Flynn to hit threes, or Siakam to hit threes, and Achiuwa to get layups, and those shots are not dropping individually in this one. I mean, Siakam, another good performance, 20 points with 5 assists and 6 rebounds, 9 for 90 from the field. The 3-point game, he's really got to get back. If Siakam wants to get back to that 23-point-per-game caliber, he does need to start hitting these threes again. That is 1 for 10 in his last 2 games. Good performances. Just needs to get the 3 ball back. VanVleet, like I was talking about, 15.6 for 13 shooting. Mihailuk doesn't give us a lot again, barely plays in the second half. Scotty Barnes, another great performance. 50% from the field, 50% from 3, 19 points. But other than, like, Siakam, Barnes, and VanVleet, there isn't a lot from this team. Achiuwa, like, horribly underwhelms again. 1 for 18 from the field. The bench was better today, or yesterday. Bench was better. Yuta Watanabe was a great boost. I hope he can find some consistency from 3. That'll help us a lot because he is such a good defender. Banton, not having the effect he was having earlier in the season. Bonga, solid defensively. Got to find that offensive rhythm in the NBA that he brings to the 905 games. Boucher, little cameo, positive offensively. And Malachi Flynn. Malachi Flynn's got to figure out what he can do for this team. What can Malachi Flynn bring to this team for it to be successful? Because right now, Malachi Flynn steps on the floor. He chucks up shots. He barely hits any of them. He was 1 for 7 from 3. He started the game 0 for 6 from 3. Like, what does Malachi Flynn bring to this team? We got to figure that out. So, ultimately, depth is lacking, and it is extremely apparent that we need a center. We need a center. Achiuwa isn't cutting it. He's not ready for this role. He's 22 years old. Say what you want about that age. he's not ready to be a center getting this many minutes for an NBA team. You need to go out and get a new one. We don't know if a new one is going to be coming to this team. That's the reality. We don't have enough depth to really compete. It's very apparent, especially with injuries. It's even more glaring. This team just does not have enough talent on the roster to compete on a night-to-night basis. It's the sad reality as it comes to the Toronto Raptors. Like Siakam, Barnes, Van Vliet give you 15, 19, and 20. Siakam has been doing well. Obviously, some things to improve. Barnes has been doing well. Some things to improve defensively for him. And Van Vliet's been great. He's all-star caliber as far as I'm concerned this season. He's all-defense caliber as far as I'm concerned this season. But just isn't enough. A very top-heavy team that just doesn't have the supporting cast to compete. And this is, you know, a team that's now 2-8 at home. The Raptors have made the Scotiabank Arena a fortress. They can't find ways to win games. They're just not able to construct 48-minute performances to go out and win games enough times. This is the fourth different time this season. We're on a 3-game losing streak. We don't have the stuff to pull us out. And it is the lack of a center who can protect the rim. And also, I mean, one on offense who can hit a layup, get 10 points a game. That would be nice as well. We don't have that. We just don't have the depth that we need to truly be competitive for an NBA season. And until that changes, until we add in those pieces, we're going to have a lot more of these tough performances to watch. I was at the game. And I noticed a lot of things. I mean, even, you know, stars aren't exempt from criticism. Like Scottie Barnes' defense still needs a lot of work. Pascal Siakam's playmaking, 5 assists is nice, but there's just a few occasions where, you know, there's that extra pass he doesn't make. There's that inside pass he just doesn't see. That could improve, but I think we're beyond the point of this unit, this group getting in rhythm. It's injuries that are affecting us. I know that, but I think we're beyond the point of this team finding its rhythm. It's been long enough. We should have found it already. Siakam, I think that he's kind of back in the flow. He's had some great performances on back-to-back-to-back nights. So I just think straight up, this team doesn't have what it needs to compete. We got to kind of face the facts. It's not as good as other teams in the league. The Eastern Conference especially is stacked this season. It's absolutely stacked this season. And we're not at the level of those other teams. We're kind of just have to see how this season plays out and hope that more individual performances kind of make this season worth watching, like Scottie Barnes' development, like Fred VanVleet trying to be an all-star, like Siakam getting better, whether it be for an off-season trade or for building around him in the future. We just don't really know what the future holds. But until then, we're going to have to sit through these performances. I'm going to continue to do it because there are watchable things about this team, like Scottie Barnes, that make it worthwhile. I don't think it's quite as bad or will get quite as bad as that Tampa season, but much work needs to be done. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Please, if you enjoyed the post-game show, let's get to 50 likes on this video. Show your support to the channel. We usually get a ton of comments. Leave a like as well to show other people that this is a video worth watching, and subscribe for more post-game shows in the future. It goes a long way to supporting the brand, supporting my editor, and everything else about Amateur Studios. We'll see you again next time for another post-game show.